Hello everybody, and welcome back to Certified Collectibles. If you've been watching our channel for a while, you may remember back in December of 2020, we actually did a unboxing of a group of Zellers branded Atari 2600 video games that we just bought from a 100 collector. We did an unboxing of the actual acquisition before we ever sent them off to WATA. Now, we typically don't do that. We typically wait to get our grades back before we show you guys, but that was such a cool group. You know, you just don't see sealed, unopened Zellers titles for the Atari 2600 ever, and we haven't seen any since. So that was such a cool group that we brought in. We sent them off to WATA. We thought we were going to get them back in 4 or 5 months to show you guys. It's been about a year, a little over a year. We finally got all 6 games back here. We got some of them back about a month ago. We had to wait to get the rest of them back so we can actually shoot this video and show you guys all the games at once. Now, if you don't recall that video, or if you need a brief history of Zellers, Zellers was a discount Canadian retailer that kind of rose to infamy back in the 80s for selling knockoffs or counterfeit Atari 2600 video games. Now, these were all Taiwanese hacks of video games that were popular at the time. So I think they did about 18 of them before Atari sued them and they had to stop selling the games. So there's only 18 Zellers branded Atari 2600 video games out there in the world. We had 6 of them. So this is about 30% of the entire catalog. Super excited to cut into this and actually see what grades we got from, you know, a year ago. So super cool group here. Let's go ahead and cut in these and show you guys what we got. What's cool is it came in these little small boxes, so we don't have a huge box to battle with today. There's a lot of collectors that just collect these Taiwanese hacks, you know. These are becoming very popular with collectors because they're just super rare to find unopened. Okay. All right, let's see what we have here. Our first one is Time Warp. This is a 7.5 no seal. Now, it's important to send these off to WATA and get the no seal designation because these games were never tape sealed, they were never glue sealed, and they were never cellophane sealed. So WATA actually had to inspect each of these with a magnifying glass to make sure there's no color breaking along the edges of the top and bottom of the box, that they truly have never been open. So it's important if you're actually buying these titles. A lot of them have been open. A lot of people say they haven't been open, but they have. So it's really important to have someone at a grading company that you trust look at them and make sure that they haven't actually ever been open, because you know, the difference between an opened version of these games and a sealed version is considerable. An open version of these games, these Taiwanese hacks, $5 or $6. Sealed versions like this, you're talking about easily over $1,000 because there just are none. This is super cool here. This is 7.5. We didn't expect super high grades on these, but we just wanted to make sure they were indeed sealed and unopened. That is super cool. Time Warp. You see by the awful graphics there. I mean, like I said, incredibly collectible. People love these Taiwanese hacks. And there's not a lot of them out there. There's very, very, very few sealed. So if you guys collect these counterfeits or these knockoff games, getting them sealed, you know what I'm talking about. Here we have game number 2, Dragon Treasure. Another 7.5 no seal. This is a port of Dragonfire that was originally produced by iMagic, I believe. Now, on the back of this label here, it actually says unopened, manufactured with no seal. That's important. Like I said, a lot of these knockoffs that people did open and play because they were just folded down, you know, it's easy to dupe unexperienced collectors into believing they were actually sealed and never opened. Super cool. Another title there. Like I said, the graphics are just ridiculously cheap, but a really cool game to add to your collection. All right, third game. Oh, our best grade yet. Here we have Laser Volley. Now, this is an 8.0 no seal. This was Laser Gates by iMagic as well. Laser Volley is the knockoff version. Like I said, these Taiwanese hacks, super cool to get find these sealed. You know, there's a lot of them out there that are pretty busted up and beat up on the market that are open. If you're just collecting, if you're just trying to put together a collection of sealed Taiwanese hacks, it's pretty, I wouldn't say easy to do, but you could definitely do it if you're just looking for the carts or the complete in box. I wouldn't even say complete in box are that easy. If you're looking for carts or, you know, just beat up versions of them, they're out there, but these sealed ones, you know, if you're looking for five sealed ones in 1 year, I don't think you'd ever find that. I think the best you'd probably ever do is one or two, maybe. Like I said, we've never seen any more since we bought this group. All right. Our last three. Like I said, we didn't expect a lot of high grades on these. We just wanted to make sure they were encapsulated and verify that they were never open. Okay, game number four, Freeway. Now, once again, a 7.0, no seal. This receives an honorable mention for the most innovative game in 1982 at the third annual Archie Awards. This is a knockoff of Freeway, the actual Atari 2600 video game. This didn't have a different title. This was actually called Freeway on the Atari 2600 as well. This here is a 7.0 no seal. Like I said, didn't expect high grades on these, but just super cool to get these verified that they were unopened. Two more games. Oh, it's one of my favorites. Here we have game number five. This is, which one was this? Here we have game number five. This is Challenge. This is a 7.5 no seal. This was released in Europe as My Way, developed by Funvision. Now, once again, these are all Zellers branded games. You can see up here in the top right corner, it says Zellers, and they have a Zellers price there and a little Zellers price block. That's how you know they're actually the Zellers branded titles. Super cool. Once again, like I said, these Zellers games, you don't see pop up that often. All right, our last game. Oh, and the lowest grade as well. Going out with a flutter. Here we have Circus, 6.5, no seal. Now this is a copy of Circus Atari, of course. Once again, like I said, the Zeller's little price sticker up there, it's on all of them. I didn't point it out on the previous ones. 6.5 on this one. These boxes are not in great shape. You know, if you look at them, you can definitely see some color rubbing, and you see some dings in the corner, some minor crushing. You know, for sealed Zeller's titles, they're actually in immaculate condition, because we never, you know, I don't think WATA or VGA has graded any of these at all. So I'm sure these are the only ones in the whole population. So these are probably the highest pop, the highest grade. But still, you can see a little bit of, you know, color breaking, you know, along the edges where they're minor crushing, a little bit of corner dings. They're not great condition, but like I said, probably the top pop, probably the only ones you'll ever see sealed and graded by WATA or VGA. So there you have our six little games we got back from WATA. Sorry that it took so long to get them back. A little over a year. We thought we'd have them back a lot sooner. Please feel free to drop some comments in the comment section below. Thumbs up if you like this video. And as always, please remember to subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you for joining us here at Certified Collectibles, and we'll see you again next time.